With Arcane's second season finally here, I found myself rewatching season 1. I was reminded that what makes this series truly unforgettable isn't just its stunning visuals or captivating worlds, it's the raw, complex journeys of its characters. Jinx, in particular, stands out as more than just a typical villain. How did this bright-eyed young girl, once known as Potter, become the chaotic villain we all know today? To find out, join me as we delve into Jinx's tragic transformation, exploring how childhood trauma can shape our destinies. Before she became the infamous Jinx, she was just Potter, a young girl full of hope and wonder living in the gritty undercity of Zond. Potter had one person she could always rely on, her older sister Vi. For Potter, Vi was more than just family. She was a protector, a role model, and her hero. Vi's confidence and bravery were everything Potter aspired to, and she desperately wanted to make her proud, to feel like she belonged in Vi's world. But as much as she tried, Potter often struggled to keep up. Her clumsiness and inexperience would often get in the way, leading to moments that chipped away at her confidence. While Vi and her gang seemed to deal with dangerous situations, Potter found herself stumbling, fumbling, or breaking things in the worst moments. Her inventions, created with innocent ambition, often backfired, making her feel more like a burden than an asset. But despite her struggles, Potter's heart was set on showing her worth to Vi. She just needed one chance to prove that she could be brave and strong, just like her sister. This desire to prove herself, combined with the innocent yearning to belong, became the spark that would ignite a tragic path. The catalyst for her transformation came when she made a desperate attempt to save everyone she loved. Potter believed that by finally proving her worth to Vi and the others, she would at last find the acceptance she longed for. She poured her heart and hopes into her plan, imagining herself as the hero who would save the day. But in a tragic twist, her attempt to help went catastrophically wrong. Instead of saving her loved ones, her efforts unleashed a devastating explosion that claimed the lives of her friends and their father figure, Vander. In an instant, Potter's world was shattered. Her heart, once filled with dreams of acceptance and belonging, was now weighed down by a crushing guilt. She wasn't just mourning those she loved. She was haunted by the feeling that her hands have brought their deaths. As Potter looked to Vi, desperate for solace and understanding, she saw only grief and anger reflected back. Vi, overwhelmed by her own pain, lashed out, unable to bear the devastation that had taken place. In one anguished moment, she pushed Potter away, leaving her younger sister feeling utterly abandoned. For Potter, this wasn't just rejection. It felt like confirmation that she was unworthy of love, of forgiveness, of belonging. In that instant, Potter's sense of self collapsed. She internalized all the blame, believing that every tragedy was a reflection of her own brokenness. She was no longer simply Potter. She became the embodiment of every mistake, every failure, and every loss. After being abandoned in her most vulnerable moment, Potter was left adrift. Lost and broken in this fragile state, Silco found her. An outcast himself who knew all too well the depth of abandonment and pain. Sensing the emptiness left by Vi's rejection, Silco became the father figure that Potter desperately needed. Someone who wouldn't turn away, no matter her flaws. But this acceptance came with strings attached. As Silco subtly began reshaping her raw pain, turning it into something far more volatile. Silco took Potter's shattered identity and guided her towards a new one. He stoked the fires of her resentment, whispering words that framed her past mistakes not as accidents, but as the marks of someone who was destined to be feared, not loved. Through his eyes, Potter wasn't just a clumsy girl, but a powerful force. If only she could embrace that darker side. Silco encouraged her to let go of the hope and innocence that had once defined her, and finally, embrace an identity free from guilt or attachment. As Potter transformed into Jinx, her mind became a battleground. The weight of past traumas and the new expectations Silco placed on her twisted her thoughts, manifesting in paranoia and bursts of violent emotion. She was haunted by hallucinations of the friends she had lost, their voices echoing her deepest fears and insecurities, reminding her of the pain she carried yet couldn't release. Her world became one of chaos and fear, a constant cycle of pushing people away while aching for connection. Trapped between a longing for her sister and an unwielding loyalty to Silco. In her actions, we see Jinx's internal struggle played out. The need for control juxtaposed with the outbursts of fury and unpredictability. Each explosion she sets off, each dangerous weapon she creates, is both an expression of power and a plea for understanding. A fractured attempt to cope with the emotions she can't fully understand or escape. Jinx's laughter, her maniacal delight in destruction, are the defense mechanisms of someone who has buried their pain so deep that chaos becomes the only form of release. Silco's manipulation filled the void in her life, but it also chained her to a distorted version of herself, one that thrived on unpredictability and fear. In her journey from Powder to Jinx, we see the tragedy of a person reshaped by trauma and influenced by someone who used her vulnerability for their own ends. Jinx became both a creation of Silco's influence and a haunting reminder of how unresolved pain can spiral into a self-destructive identity that consumes everything in its path. Jinx's story is a powerful exploration of how childhood trauma can shape who we are, often in ways we may not realize. Her journey from Powder to Jinx is not just a tale of a girl who loses her way. It's a story about the lasting scars that early experiences of pain, loss, and abandonment can leave on our hearts and minds. In Jinx, we see the raw and often invisible impact of trauma, and how the need for acceptance can lead us to reshape ourselves, sometimes even into the versions we no longer recognize. The pain we experience early on can become a lens through which we see the world, affecting our decisions and leading us into patterns that seem inescapable. Jinx's fractured identity is a reminder of how trauma can leave us feeling torn between who we are and who we think we need to be to survive. But her story is also a call for compassion. We may not be able to rewrite the past, but we can seek to understand it. By facing our own traumas, we can begin to separate who we truly are from the pain that once defined us. Jinx reminds us that behind every action, there's a story, and behind every scar, there's a person who was once just like Powder, innocent, hopeful, and longing to be loved. In recognizing this, perhaps we can find the strength to heal and to support others on their own journey towards peace. And as Jinx's journey showed us, trauma doesn't have to be the end of the story. It may shape us, but it doesn't have to define us. Healing is possible, and by facing our pain, we can begin to find a way forward. A way to reclaim our true selves and build a life not marked by the wounds of our past, but by the resilience we find within. Hey! If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe for more deep dives into amazing stories like this. If you got a topic you'd like to see me cover, drop your ideas in the comments below. This is Entomania. Thank you for watching.